Hello everyone, I'm Pam Murphy, the host of a new and exciting show being brought to you by Time Warner Access 23 TV, right here down in Port Jervis, New York. My whole life has been centered around teaching and educating children, and I wanted to bring some of that, what I have done in my life, some of that culture to everyone around me. So please sit back and relax tonight and enjoy a huge night that we have planned for you, and it's full of music, dance, drama, and art. But most of all, remember, it's fun. So enjoy it. I would like to present to you first a number that I wrote called Serenity Now. One of the music teachers that lived in my area in Walden, New York, passed away almost a year ago, as you'll be watching this. And I wrote a song in dedication to her. She was one of my former students that I had in class. And then she got to be one of my colleagues. And that's the nice thing about this business is that your students or your people that you have maybe taught grow up and become your colleagues. And unfortunately, she passed away about a year ago, and this song is in dedication to her. So you'll be listening to a song called Serenity Now. And you'll also then be watching a wonderful, talented young lady who I teach. Her name is Emma Bilyou. You'll be watching her perform live at the Apollo Theater. That's right, the Apollo Theater, the notorious, infamous Apollo Theater, which is located in Harlem, New York. She recently went down and she competed in amateur night and graced the beautiful stage with her gorgeous voice. So you'll be listening to her sing a solo as well. So sit back, as I said, relax, enjoy. And now I bring to you my wonderful show called PAM Time.
I met her in my younger years, so full of life, had nothing to fear. She took to her music and wanted to teach, had so much to give, her message could reach. She got a good job doing what she loved. Each shining day filled with rhymes from above, and on her desk was a prayer of praise, filling her spirit when it needed a raise. Serenity now is all I ask. Am I up to the challenge? Am I up? She met this great guy, he's the love of her life. As time went by, he made her his wife. They laughed every day and danced a slow beat. Her children's voice echoed all through the street. The pathless taken that becomes forsaken as her course suddenly shaken. Stand tall, have no fear. Her message was clear. It's God's faith, but I'll be all right here. Serenity now is all I ask. Am I up to the challenge?
Female vocalist from Middletown, New York.
Mm-hmm. Woo!
You know it's good when the audience goes, woo! Yeah, don't trip. Don't be embarrassed. You see that step, huh? You saw him trip and then he gonna act like his leg was hurt.
Hi, welcome back. Again, I'm Pam Murphy, your host of the new show, Pam Time, featuring the performing arts. So you just watched some clips that I told you you'd enjoy. Here's another whole set of clips that I got for you from my coffee house night, which I host annually. I have a Valentine's coffee house and usually a Halloween coffee house. And I'll tell you what, I get some wonderful, talented people from ages like kids ages 5 all the way up to adults who come out and do these shows. So I put together a whole night full of stuff for you to watch. You don't even have to come to my theater to do that. You can sit on your couch and watch these. So let me just read off who I have for you. Stephanie Restuccia, who's going to be playing guitar and singing two songs that she wrote, two original songs, My Dearest Love and Two Fish in the Sea. Then right after that, we have a teacher feature. So three of our teachers who teach dance at the Hudson Valley Conservatory, which is in Walden, New York, 35 East Main Street, put together this montage. They are Melanie Cascella, who's going to tap, Briana DiLeo taps, and then Claire Beebe will be doing a beautiful jazz number during this song. Right after that, I have Matthew Gillespie, who's singing a wonderful, lovely love ballad, and Maya Hebbard kind of does some acting along with him. And shortly after that is a skit from Loren O'Connell and Zach Kiernan. And I don't even know what they called it. I think it was like a Radio Time skit or something like that. And with voices Tim Murphy, Matt Gillespie, and Kate Burns. And then followed up by a wonderful duet by Gabe Vargas and Jade Imperata. JP, Jenn, and Brian Stabner will finish that portion out by playing some of his original songs from his band, Brian Stabner. Then, shortly after that, you'll see a Falling Slowly song, which was from our HVC dance company. Hudson Valley Conservatory dancers went and competed. So you get to watch the dances of D. Wright Kelly, who choreographed this and put it on. You'll see Taylor Rosenberger, Briana DiLeo, Madison Pomerico, and Brianna Blair. So again, enjoy.
Good times.
mama special in the audience, and you know who you are. This next song is about just, you know, we all have bad times, but like we all get through it. We're all just fish in the sea, trying to find our way. So this song is called Fish in the Sea. I think you should enjoy it.
Oh, I'm Jacob Jacobson.
And I'm Barb Benson.
And it's 8:30 here at PAMT Radio. Oh. Which of course means it's time for lovely, lovely lovers' leisure hour.
True. We'll be playing some of our favorite songs, taking calls, giving some dating advice, all just in time for Valentine's Day.
All right, let's start the hour off right. Our first caller, you're on the air with B&J.
Hey guys, this is Doug.
Hey Doug, what's your trouble?
So, me and this girl, Debussy, have been seeing each other for a while now. She's really amazing. She really is. She smells like pumpkin spice and crushed dreams. She has a great personality. She likes it dark and bold, just like me.
Saucy.
All right, well, what seems to be the problem, Doug?
It just feels like we never have time to be alone. We're always having the same conversation. It feels like it's hard for us to open up to one each other.
Well, that's a tough one, Big D. Have you tried telling Debussy any of this?
Like I said, I've tried, but every time I do, Cassandra tells me to stop being weird and get back to work. And when I call her name, she acts like she doesn't know me. It hurts my feelings that she acts like that, just like the rest of them.
Who is the rest of them?
The customers? The other customers.
Doug, question. Are you in a relationship with this girl?
Well, relationship is a strong word, but I think it's going somewhere. Anyway, my question is, when would be a good time to tell my mom about this? You know, because of me and Debbie, and I take things to the next level, then I didn't borrow the car more often, so I think I have to tell my mom.
How old are you, Doug?
27. Hold on.
Cassandra, I'll be done in a second. Just wait. God.
Stop.
Doug, where are you right now?
At work. I work at Starbucks. Oh, also, would it be weird if I check her out on Valentine's Day where I work? I get a discount.
All right. Let's take another caller. Hopefully not as weird as that one. You're on the air with J&B.
Hi.
What's your name?
It's Josh.
Okay. Hi, Joshua. Where are you calling?
I have a bad Valentine's Day story.
We love those.
Go ahead, Josh.
Okay, so I met this chick in class, and I was like, hey. So I brought her down, and I was like, look, can you go on a date with me? And she was like, sure. So I brought her to McDonald's. No, don't laugh. I brought her inside so we didn't have to go to the drive-thru.
Wow.
And so I was like, you can get two things off the dollar menu, including a drink. And she was like, ugh. And I was like, ugh. And she was like, so that's not enough. And I was like, fine. So I just broke down, cried at McDonald's. I had to call my mom. She had to come pick me up because she had to drive my car home. And that's the end of my story.
Wow, that was something.
Yeah, but then I got famous because my mom posted a picture of myself at McDonald's on Instagram. So whatever, it's all good.
Sounds great. Well, better luck next time, Joshua.
All right, let's take another caller. Hello, you're on the air.
Hi, my name's Emily.
Hi, Emily. What's your question?
I've been with my boyfriend for 2 years, and I really like him, but he got offered this amazing job, but it's in Belgium. He wants me to go with him, but I can't relocate. I just can't. I have family here. A job.
What's your job, Emily?
I'm a radiologist.
Well, great luck. There's tons of bugs to examine in Europe. So I'm sure you can find a good job over there.
That's an entomologist, not a radiologist. And I'm not even sure that what you're saying is correct.
Yeah, but you know what? Belgium is the capital of Europe. Huge country. It's very vast. You know what? And it's known for its pancakes.
Delicious.
Invented chocolate, actually.
It's
that. I just don't know if I can move my whole life. I mean, everyone I know is here.
Well, all right, Emily, are you listening?
Are you listening, Emily?
This is what you should do. Get ready, girl, because I'm about to make it real. Go down the city hall, get a passport, go to Belgium with your boyfriend, change your name, cut your hair, dye your hair, create a new identity. Leave the old you behind.
Leave it behind, Emily.
Get a new job. Fighting bugs is so overrated. Be a pancake maker, I don't know, something delicious. They get a new family. They have tons of family.
They have tons of family.
You can do it, Emily.
You can do it.
That doesn't even make logical sense.
Listen, it's really not that hard. I did it.
What?
What? I didn't know.
Okay, next caller. Hi.
Hi, I'm Anita.
How can we help you, Anita?
Well, my worst Valentine's Day story happened about 4 years ago after secretly dating two guys.
Very West Side Story.
Well, their names were Dan and Greg.
Very gossip. Love that. Keep going.
So, for a few months, I told Greg I didn't want a relationship so that I could get serious with Dan.
Okay, got it.
On Valentine's Day, Dan took me out to dinner, and I literally snorted water out of my nose when our waiter arrived.
Graceful.
It was great.
What?
Yeah, as in my ex-boyfriend, Greg.
Uh-oh.
The one I dumped for Dan.
This is getting even better. Keep going, Anita.
To make matters worse, Dan ordered a dish that Greg used to make all the time, which he loved. He gushed to the waiter, a.k.a. Greg, a.k.a. my ex.
Yikes.
If she could cook like this, I'd marry her. Surprise! Dan Greg had already beat you to that, and I said no.
How did it end?
Greg gave Dan a special discount for dinner.
Well, how did it work out with you and Dan?
Well, we broke up not too long after that.
Oh, sorry, girl.
Well, which is fine, because the last I heard from Dan, Tim and Greg were very happy together.
Thank you for calling, Anita. That will last us all night.
Well, that concludes our hour here at PAMT Radio. Glad you all could join us for the Lonely Lovers Leisure Hour. We'll be playing one of our favorite tunes to take us out. Join us again tomorrow. BMJ out.
Do you hear me? I'm talking to you. Across the water, across the deep blue ocean, under the open sky. Oh my, baby, I'm trying.
Boy, I hear you in my dreams. I feel you whisper across the sea. I keep you with me in my heart. You make it easier when life gets hard. Lucky I'm in love with my best friend. Lucky to have been where I have been. Lucky to be coming home again.
Thank you. show. Remember, these fire EPs can sell right in the back, only $5 on iTunes, all that good stuff. Brett Stabner, music on Facebook, and everything like that. Thank you so much.
So the next thing you're going to be watching is the Hudson Valley Conservatory's vocal ensemble, and they're going to be doing their rendition of Green Day's 21 Guns. It is outstanding. I can't wait for you to watch it. This again was performed at the New Rose Theater in Walden, and we're bringing it here for you guys to watch as well. Inside the ensemble, you're going to hear Kate Burns, Megan Blair, Cammie McCarthy, Sam Gleason, Lauren O'Connell, Tim Murphy, Billy Blair, Veronica Hebbard, Sydney Amon, Dylan Johnson, Aixa Garcia, and Claire Beebe. Together, their voices blend, and you're going to hear the song 21 Guns.
You're in ruin. I'm in ruin. One. you're in ruins.
121 guns, lay down your arms, give up the fight. 121 guns, throw up your arms into the sky.
21 Performers amazing. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I love watching it. I'm so proud of each and every single one of them. So we brought to you some local kids and some local talent, and I'm sure in your community out there you have some equally talented people. Get out there and enjoy it. The whole idea of my show PAM Time is to showcase the wonderfully talented people in our area and give you a chance to watch it. So I encourage everyone who's out there, get up to your local theater, audition, or go down to your local station and sing. Or get out there and do whatever, because you know, when you're singing, your life is a lot happier. So I'd like to thank you again, and welcome to PAM Time, my wonderful show where we tap into the performing arts. So I'd like to thank you all for watching. I'm Pam Murphy. Goodbye and good night.